Hello everybody. In this video I will introduce you how to scripting in SAP with C#. Please don't forget to like the video and subscribe my channel. In order to automate with C# in SAP, you need to insert the DLLs to UiPath. You can do this as follows. Navigate to Manage Packages. And then navigate to All Packages. Write in the search box, SAP GUI. Install the package. After installing, you can use these DLLs in your code to automate SAP with VB.NET or also with C#. Add activity, invoke code. Change the programming language to C#. At the beginning, we need to connect to the SAP application and get the connection and session. These can we do with this part of code. Before we continue with the code, I will show you how to define the individual items in SAP. We will see what the statement looks like and what parts does a statement consist of. To define each element in SAP, we need the following statement, which consists of 6 parts. This statement below is just an example to define the main window. The first part is always the same. SAFUS comes from the DLL that we imported at the beginning of the video. The second and fourth parts are the same. It is the element type. That means, for example, we use GUI text field for a text field. GUI button for a button. GUI radio button for a radio button. GUI frame window for a SAP window. You can choose the name by yourself. It is better to always take the type of the element at the beginning, then the name of the element, for example text currency, or button process open items. Part 5 is GUI session.find by ID. GUI session is the variable which we defined in the code. The last part is the ID of the element in SAP. Each element in SAP has an ID. We use this ID to find the element correctly. For example, Windows 0, or Windows 0 toolbar 1 button 17. After we have defined the elements, I will now show you which functions are available for each element type. Because each element has different functions, I have listed a few element types that are used the most. I will show you a few functions for each type. The first type is window. This has, for example, these functions: maximize, minimize, get text, send V key, set focus, and close. The second type is session. These has the following functions: start transaction, end transaction, find by ID, get name, create session, and find by position. The third type is button. Functions are, for example, press, get name, set focus, and convert to string. The next type is a radio button. Functions: select, set focus, get name, and convert to string. The next type is text field. Functions are get text or set text, set focus, and convert to string. The next type is menu item. Functions are select, set focus, find by ID, and find by name. The last type is grid view. This has the following functions: select column, get row count, click, click current cell, double click, double click current cell, and get cell value. These types and functions were only examples. There are many different types and functions. This can be seen directly in UiPath when you write the code. Now let's continue writing the code. First, we will define the main window. We will use the statement as I showed you. First, SA foos dot. Then the element type. For window, we use GUI frame window. Then we write the name for the element. For example, main window, then equal and the element type again in brackets. Then GUI session dot find by ID. Then we write the ID for the element, that means the ID for the window. It is window 0. Now we are going to use the element we have defined with a maximize function to maximize the window. And now we will start a transaction, for example, F32. Sometimes UiPath doesn't directly accept the type element. You have to add SA foos before the type. Now I will run the code to see how it works. I have already opened SAP before I ran the code. The code should first maximize the main window. Then it will start the transaction F32. We are now in transaction F32. At the end of the video, I will briefly summarize what we learned in the video. We imported the DLLs that we need for SAP scripting. After that, I wrote the code to connect to SAP, then I showed you what a statement looks like. At the end, I had an example to maximize the main window and start transaction F32. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something interesting from it. See you in the next video.